What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another vlog. If this is your first time coming, excuse me, I'm trying to do my intro.
I'm trying to vlog here.
Sorry about that.
I'm walking here.
I'm walking here. What's up, everybody? So, if this is your first time on my channel, my name is Shaun. It's great to meet you all. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you guys never miss any one of my videos. And hit that post notification button so that you always get a notification when I drop a video. But this feels a little bit weird vlogging because I haven't vlogged in a while. I'm with the usual people, except we got a new kid. So this is my homie Javen. This is the first time meeting this kid. We met on Instagram. He DM'd or
I actually reached out to her first.
Yeah, he reached out to Kalina. That's right. He reached out to Kalina, and then he saw my Hawaiian ass, and he's from the islands too, which is pretty dope. And so him and I were both just like, "Yo, let's link and let's go shoot some stuff."
Link
so
build,
right now we're kind of just walking through some weird roads and forests. Because we're probably going to go get some cool pictures and stuff. And I think we're going to go down to, like, downtown Portland, go film, go down to some sneaker boutiques. So, I don't know. Really just do whatever, but I'm vlogging. So, you guys know how it goes with my vlogs. It's kind of just, like, random, not really organized, and we do whatever we like. So, yee. I'm going to just keep getting some B-roll, keep filming a little bit, and I will catch up with y'all in a sec.
I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got some bitches in my life and they all mine. I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got some bitches in my life and they all mine. I got a pocket full of sunshine. Look at all these diamonds on my neck, bitch, they all shine. Looking at my jewelry for too long, you might go blind. I could put a bag on your head, that's a gold mine. Homie got the Maggie, got the Glock and the Tech 9. Camo with the Adidas track pants, I got the old kind. I just had a Pisces, she one night, mean she was so fine. Missed the nasty time, I fucked the face, then she rolled my.
What's good, y'all? So we finished up trekking down in the forest because, you know, we had to go Tarzan mode for a little bit. But right now we are back downtown. We're about to head over to the sneaker boutique. But Tic Tac over here wanted to do some... Oh, look at that pose. Look at that. Look at that pose. Damn. Okay. So I think we're going to go in the compound. Hopefully my homie Lauren is working because him and I always have good-ass conversations. But I think we're going to head to lunch after that. And like I said before, you guys know my vlogs. We kind of just go along with the day, don't really have a plan. Like, I'll let you guys know what I'm doing, but that always changes. So, we're just gonna have a dope ass day with the new Cuddy, because it's the first time in this video, and hopefully if he stays here on the mainland, he'll be in a whole lot more videos. So, we have some plans for summer, which will be fucking dope. And he has a drone, which is gonna be sick, so we'll get a bunch of cool ass footage of that shit. But I'll let the females take some pictures and everything like they want to do, and I'll hop on back with you guys in a sec.
Hey, you in this?
What am I looking at?
Mine.
Squad pig.
Here it is, a groove slightly transformed. Just a bit of a break from the norm. Just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance?
Give me I was texting on my phone and no music, no nothing. All of a sudden I hear this like scratching on the wall and I was like, what the heck? It was like in the last 4 months.
Yo, we're talking about ghost stories because we're eating that Old Town Pizza right now, and it's like high key, it's haunted. It's like there's a bunch of stories about it being haunted. Like apparently there's been like ghosts that like walk up along there, and then this like right where we're sitting apparently used to be an old elevator shaft, and apparently somebody like fell down and died like right here. And then this is like also where the Shanghai tunnels were. So if you guys are like from Portland and you probably know about the Shanghai tunnels, so this is like kind of where all that stuff used to start. And so there's been a lot of people who have died here, and like a lot of spirits and shit like that. So this place is pretty sketchy, but it's kind of cool. It's a cool little aesthetic to it. So, but yeah, so that was a backstory. Kalina was telling a horror story about her old apartment. Well, her apartment now, but not really any more haunted things here. So we ordered our pizza. We're gonna eat. Actually, I see a pizza right now.
Maybe not. That wasn't a pizza.
Do you guys ever have those times when you get like super excited because you see your server coming, and you think it's there? You think they're carrying your food, and then they just like veer off right at the last second and go over to someone else's table. Such a sad moment.
The crab pizza is the pizza absolutively. Pizza, 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 pizza.
Alright y'all, so we just had a great ass fucking lunch. We have the new member to the squad. We got Scott in here with us. Hey. So now we have our group of five, but I think we're kind of just gonna walk around Portland. It's a little bit nasty, so we won't be doing it for a while. You guys notice the little raindrops. Excuse you.
My bad.
I can feel that. I'm trying to steal my...
Dying.
This is actually slippery.
And Javen almost died. No cop, no stop.
No cop, no stop.
Yeah. You know we rocking the Yeezys downtown though. We gotta make it. We gotta make it look nice. And then there's Kalina's trash ass shoes.
Hey.
You know.
I'm on sale.
Hey, I got them on sale. I love these people. They're so fun.
Shaun died. We said the floor is lava.
Yeah, well, I'm filming.
Hey, give you a sick photo.
I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got some bitches in my life and they all mine. I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got some bitches in my life.
Hey, hello.
Oh, I can't wait till it's summer, guys, because I just went up, so I went up on that little ledge right there, and we took a few, if it wants to focus, that'd be, oh, there we go, thank you. So I went up on that ledge, took a few pictures, but can't wait until it's, like, summertime and it's all dry, because then I can actually, like, go up and, like, hang off stuff like I used to do with rap and all that type of stuff, because then it makes for sick-ass, like, adventure pictures and crazy cool, like, I don't know, editorial pictures and stuff like that. So I miss those days, but not too much longer, although... Oregon spring has been really weird. Like, it's usually sunny and warm by now, but it's been raining and terrible lately, so it kind of sucks. But yo, so I have some really good news. So
he's
I'm not
pregnant.
Sure. Yeah. So I have a baby. I'm 8 weeks pregnant right now. So it's pretty amazing. I'm naming him Pineapple. You know, we got to do that. So good news. So I may have told you guys that I'm going to Paradiso with these people, minus Javen. I don't think he's gonna be able to go, but so I'm going to Paradiso, and I reached out to a few different artists and was asking if any of them needed a videographer. And so I hit up Sonholo and his management team, and I was just asking them, like, yo, could I possibly be a videographer for Sonholo? And so thankfully, which was really cool, they actually reached back to me, and they said in their email that Sonholo already has his media set, but there's an artist called Tasca Black, who some of you guys may have heard of. I actually, when they emailed me, I had no idea who he was. I had never heard of him before, and so right after they emailed me that, I went and looked him up, looked up some of his songs, and he's actually a great artist. So like, actually, I'll go link down below like some of his songs and his most recent album. But you guys should definitely go check out his music. Like, he's a great EDM artist. But what's really cool is I'm gonna be filming for him at Paradiso, so I'm hella excited to go do that. And I'll obviously be posting all those pictures on my Instagram and videos on my Instagram, and then I'll have a full set edit on my YouTube that I'll post for you guys. And I'm gonna be vlogging a little bit, and I'm gonna try to do like a whole festival video at Paradiso, so you guys will all see that. So it's super cool, and some super cool plans on the way, in the works for you guys. So yeah, so we're all just kind of we're doing us right now, you know, all the random stuff. But
She's like, oh.
We're having some fun, so I'll just keep on, I'll keep on filming all my random shit, and hope you guys enjoy. Y'all, she really just did that all the way across the street. Oh my god. I did. I recorded part of it, not all of it. Oh, what's up, everybody? So, we just got back home from downtown. So, with Javen here, and now that I have another Islander homie, I felt like it might be a funny video. Him and I both were thinking about this, that it might be a funny video to try and bring out some Hawaiian pidgin phrases to these people that don't know and don't speak Hawaiian or have ever talked in pidgin or have ever heard it. It's gonna be interesting. me and Javen picked out a few phrases that I definitely don't think they're gonna get. And then later, we picked out 12 words that are like kind of small little words, and we're gonna do like a speed round. And so we're gonna like list them off, and you guys just have to say like the first thing that comes to your mind. So I'm going to turn my computer around and you guys will read the first one and you'll try to pronounce it, and then you guys will all have to try to guess what you think it means. And then after everyone guesses, we'll explain what it means. Oh, so you guys ready?
No.
I feel like they're fairly simple. Like, it shouldn't be that hard to catch on to, but yeah, at the same time.
Yeah, there's a few that like are definitely going to be hard, but most of these are pretty not that hard. You guys ready?
Yeah, we
good. Okay.
Round one. Fight!
Go at a time, like, though.
Yeah, one at a time. So, Kalina, you start first and read the top, the number one.
Broke the mouth. I remember you.
This one was in the video that I showed you guys a couple weeks ago.
Just guess, just go for it.
Is that like when you stutter?
When you what?
Okay. When you stutter?
No.
Okay, wait, Scott.
Just someone's like super upset, just going off.
Actually, that's not a bad guess. That's like,
that's reasonable.
Not
that's
right,
reasonable.
But it's not a bad guess. That's like logical. Okay, Brandon, what do you think?
Broke the mouth? is it bad or is it funny?
It's good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's good.
Oh no.
It's a good thing?
Yeah, it's a good thing.
Oh man. I have no idea.
Just a random guess. Like,
is it like when someone does something good?
No.
No? Or something stupid?
Should we give like a category? I feel like.
No, that'll give it away.
It's either like you got hit in the mouth, or it's the one where you're like, you chew so much that it like is so good. You said something.
Sort of.
So
you're
almost
like,
there.
I don't
know,
like,
there.
It's such a good thing to eat.
Yeah.
That, like, you're just
so
like,
broke. Whoa. Yeah.
Yeah.
Broke the mouth is pretty much like when something is like on.
Yeah, yeah.
When it's delicious.
It's so good.
When it's good that it's like it breaks your mouth, it breaks your taste buds because it tastes so good.
That's what I did.
I'm way too uncomfortable.
Broke the mouth. Okay, second one.
This was like heavily used in that.
Yeah. Number two.
You like scrap?
You have to say more loud.
You like scrap?
You like scrap?
Say again.
You want to fight?
She's two for two right now, bro.
What? Did I actually get that?
You actually got that right.
Now think about it out. Like, say it like louder, like, you want to scrap?
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like, you guys want to fight? That's like us. We're like, you like scrap.
Knack attack?
This one is one of the hard ones.
It's a smoothie.
This one is one of the hard ones.
Is that a smoothie somewhere?
It's a special flavor of shaved ice, dude.
That's like when you're like kayaking and you lose your balance.
No.
You pronounced that right, but like.
Knack attack?
Yeah.
Kanake. Is there like a way to say it?
It's just like knack attack.
Kanaka.
No, it's Kanaka. Not what up, bitch.
So I'm wrong.
Okay, Scott.
I got.
It's like when you eat something really good again, it's like you have like a food coma. Like, you're so like full that like you have a Kanaka attack. Right. That's how you explain
so
it.
So Kanaka attack is like, Kanaka attack is like food coma, and it's like then it's like your feeling of having a food coma, and then you go take a nap afterwards. That's like a Kanaka attack. Number four. So number four is an actual Hawaiian phrase, and it's like widely used, usually ending a conversation.
Hanau. It's
Hanau. Hanau. On a hole.
Is it like a thank you or is it like a...
It's like a hello or what's up?
On the howl!
Yeah!
Wait, how would you say it? Like the kind of tone that you'd use.
So I just had to say it already?
Yeah.
Okay, so how people like also say it like at concerts instead of saying like encore, what is encore? Saying it like, one time.
Encore?
Yeah, you say Hana Hole, like do it again, like one time. That's like, that's how I say it.
It's kind of, yeah, so like there's a couple of different, like, a lot of Hawaiian phrases have like a bunch of different ways of like saying things and different meanings and stuff. But
read that.
How's it going, brah? You wanna go to part-time? Yeah. How's it, brah? Like to go part-time?
Let's go Bombay.
Let's do Bombay.
And I'm a howling man from the mainland.
I'm a howling.
What's your best guess? Say it again.
Saying like, hey bro, what's up?
Say it fast. You have to say it fast though. Like, you don't say it slow.
How's it going, bro? You having a good time? Let's blink.
Okay, Grace, what's your guess?
Like, you wanna go out sometime? How's it going? You wanna go out sometime?
And what's the third part?
Let's go to the show.
Okay.
Together. Like, how's it going? Let's go to a party. Like, we should go to the Bombay.
I knew that last part would be the toughest.
Yeah.
How's it, bro? It's pretty easy.
Ha!
Like,
Jesus!
And two.
You're not in frame.
Okay, whatever, I'm fine.
Scoot that way, like lean up against the armrest. That's
gonna be so complicated.
Do you want to be in the video or not? So, number five, how's it, bruh? Like, go party. Like, you guys got that pretty easy. Like, those two phrases. Us go Bombay is kind of a weird way of phrasing it. We usually say, like, you go Bombay.
Yeah.
Type, but it's more like that last part is pretty much like we're about to go out, like we're about to leave,
yeah,
and go do something. Pretty much.
Bombay.
Yeah. That was the part that I was
Bombay.
Bombay. We're gonna go drink some Bombay. Oh my god. Number six. Try and pronounce number
Ooh,
six.
That's Sherry, bro.
Is it like, it's like the Hawaiian version of like the Asian glow after you're like a little too drunk and your face is just like beat red. Someone comes up to you, they're like, ooh, that's Sherry, bro.
Like, is it like saying like that's sick?
Yeah.
I guess
yeah.
So,
you're just thinking about it too much. Like,
she's analyzing everything. Can you just score the simple?
Yeah, yeah, it's like that's sick, that's dope, like something kinda like that. Like if we see a sick car, it's like, oh, that's Cherry, bro. Like,
wait,
like
you definitely said that when we hung out and I definitely just let it go.
I like the next one.
Did they already guess?
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
That number seven?
I didn't do anything.
I didn't say anything.
She texted me.
Kind of said. They just pretty much said the word.
Kill.
Yeah. Wait, hold on. I'm going over here.
His Nick level's over 9,000!
Number eight. Small. Try and guess that.
Can you make the boss
small
bigger?
Small keen or cun? Cun.
Cun.
Keen.
Smale keen.
Smale keen. Is that slang for small dick?
Small cun?
Like, why are you changing the small word?
Small person?
Okay.
It's like a small child.
Okay.
I would say child, yeah.
I have no idea. I'm not cultured, dude.
Yeah, he's white.
Okay.
Kind of word.
So, like but cakes. Small kind is like a small thing. Like, or like, when you want...
Small thing, huh?
Small kind want to drink, like...
Yeah, like you want to drink a little bit. It's like kind of like a little bit, like... You like small kind grinds, like you want to go eat a little bit or something like that.
This is my favorite.
Okay, number nine.
Honolulu Princess?
Yeah.
Is that like a drama queen? Or like a valley girl equivalent
of Hawaii?
Dad. Keep guessing.
Rich girl?
Is that what you call somebody from the States?
No. It's not like a category. It's like,
no,
it's after an action.
Complains about everything.
What's the word of someone that's from the mainland? We'll go over that later.
It's like
gringo.
You do something after.
Sean's like, oh my life. Is it like after you get sick and you're
Okay, so what it is like when you puke. It's like people call you Polo Princess because you puked. I see that at a party.
Oh, you're weak.
Yeah.
I said you when you're a dab.
You just said dab, you didn't say puke.
When you puke, you're a dab.
Oh, that's a...
And then 10. Attack. This one's not too hard.
I gotta go shishi, is that like...
That's nice.
I gotta go
shishi is pee.
Okay, okay.
I'm gonna say smoke.
My aunt was always like, you gotta go shishi, and I was like...
So, first word. 3, 2, 1. Slippers.
Slippers. Shoes. The things you put on your feet.
She said
slippers.
Okay. Say the mainland term though.
Mainland term. Like the...
Yeah.
Like slides. What do you mean mainland term?
Slippers?
Flip-flops. Oh, but it's like... So we're responding...
Sandals? A nice one with the straps on the back.
So you respond, but you say it here.
Like, what do you think would be...
So slippers.
Oh, you say slippers?
Yeah, I was saying... Slides.
Well, slippers to Hawaiians is like flip-flops to mainland. That's what slippers is. Okay. You ready for the second one?
3, 2, 1, grinds.
Food.
Got it.
Grace got that one. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, ono.
It's not family, it's not me.
Family is ohana.
Oh,
there we go.
You.
There we go.
It's like when you say, damn, this food is very ono.
Good.
Okay. Superb.
Okay, Grace got it. It's delicious. Like, tastes very good.
Don't say that here. We say dank or
fire. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Shoots.
Sorry, say that again?
Shoots.
Shoots. Moves? I feel like I know this.
Oh, it's like saying bets.
Or like...
Or it's like saying okay to something.
You could use it that way, actually.
Because that's how he used
it.
Yeah, you could, yeah.
Yep, Ralph's right.
Yeah, so you can also use it that or saying like bye. If I say bye, say shoots.
Okay, shoots, or it's like...
Because every time I text you and you're like, shoots, I'm like, what the fuck is that? I'm like, okay.
Yeah. It's like our term of bet, or like, it's like, cool, like, cool, I'm down.
Because the first time he said shoots, I was like, all right, what are we shooting?
Number 5.
Can we just cut the whole conversation
3,
out?
2, 1, okay, Roger.
Roger's okay.
I understand what you're saying. All right, we good. I got shoots.
Roger that.
Copy that, yeah.
Okay.
It's like saying okay.
I'll give it to 3, because you 3, like, answered.
No, I got that shit first. They ain't sharing points here. I got that shit flipped. So.
Number 6. 3, 2, 1. I don't care.
I don't care. You can do whatever.
Who else asks? She's fast.
I have this next one. Island.
I don't know any of this shit.
Just literally like the first thing that comes to your head.
Just see how fast you say it. Like you just say the word fast. Like saying I don't care. I don't care.
I don't care. 3, 2, 1. 3. Poto.
It's like ass. A
bitch.
It's kind of like a. That's how you say it.
Poto.
Okay, like
you. I like them big. I like them chunky. Okay, like, okay.
Gang, gang.
Okay, I'll give you guys a hint. He has a very small bullet.
Dick.
Yes.
Yeah.
But
that's 3 points for me. Take
Buttle.
The lead.
Okay, number 8. 1, 2, 3. How old are
you? How old are you?
How old are you?
Age.
How old are you?
I just... Really? What the heck?
No. It's not how old are you.
It's like...
15.
Wait, is that the word for the
mainland
people?
It kind of like calls
me
a dipshit.
Okay, we'll give that to Brennan.
Yes.
No!
Yes!
It technically is, but it's more for white people. Actually, haole originally was for anyone who wasn't any foreigner.
Dude,
anyone
I watch Hawaii Five-O. I know.
I watch Hawaii Five-O.
All right, 3, 2, 1. Decline.
Oh, decline.
No.
No, it's a...
What
the fuck is that?
My phone.
It's a very it means something very vague. Like, it's
like
not...
The kind?
The front times.
Remember what I'm thinking about, vague.
It's not really a place, so...
Better's go.
It's past 30 already.
Yeah,
so, the kind is, like, it's when you can't... It's either when you can't think of the word, the specific word, so it's like, say I wanted to say, let's go to the beach, but I can't... I just am stuttering or can't think of the word beach, so I say, let's go to kind. But it's more used in, like... If you've been talking to someone for a little bit and been having a conversation, you guys talked about going to the bar earlier in a conversation, and you're about to leave, you can say, instead of, let's go to the bar right now, you say, let's go to the kind right now. And number 10.
Did I just say it? Like, I can't say it long.
No, you can, say it how it's supposed to be said.
Okay, I'm gonna just say it, but I'm not gonna count down because, like, we can't play yell.
No.
Chew! Oh my god! Bremen Rock! It's, like.
I'm gonna do something dope.
Yeah, like, fuck yeah.
Yeah. That could be used like
he
that.
He named an eyeshadow that.
Did he really?
But it's like, chew!
Yeah.
It's like a Hawaiian yeehaw.
Yeah!
It's like this hell yeah.
It's like a Hawaiian yeehaw!
You gotta give that to Scott because he doesn't have any points. So.
Bro, I've never actually heard that analogy. That's how I'm gonna describe that to people now. It's the Hawaiian yeehaw. Like, that's legit what it is. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little Hawaiian pidgin segment. This was somewhat fun. We will.
Somewhat
fun. That's why Dad before I showed up.
It was a little more calm before Hoffa showed up, but I feel like it brought up a little more controlled. A little more controlled, but Lord knows I'm gonna be spending a little extra time editing this video now.
Damn right you are. So,
yeah, but I really hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. If you guys want me to start trying to, I mean, now that Javen's here, we can kind of start doing like a little Hawaiian type episodes where like we
series.
Let's yeah, like a little series. Like we can go with you like mainland Hawaiian food.
Yeah,
like,
that's a good one.
We should go to Roxy's. Yeah, and gets a different dish, and then they have to taste it to see.
Isn't Roxy's most whitewashed?
Yeah,
yeah.
It's like
no,
it's so good though.
It's like Hawaiian like.